What if I told you that you could run more AI workloads on your existing infra while cutting inference cost up to 98% without losing accuracy? Sounds amazing, right? That's exactly what NVIDIA's new Data Flywheel Blueprint can help achieve in real-world agentic workflows. Hi, my name is Sailendran. I work on the Generative AI Platforms team here at NVIDIA. In this video, we will look at our latest enterprise-grade reference workflow, the NVIDIA AI Blueprint for building data flywheels. If you're building AI agents powered by large models in production, you're going to love this. Here's a challenge every AI developer faces. You deployed a powerful large language model to power your AI agent, say a Llama 3.170B, and it's working great. But the inference costs are crushing your budget, and the latency is slower than you'd like. Traditional approaches require you to manually experiment with smaller models, spend weeks fine-tuning, and hope you don't sacrifice accuracy. That's precisely where you could benefit by setting up a data flywheel. A data flywheel is a self-reinforcing cycle that uses your production AI traffic, the actual prompts and responses your users generate, to automatically discover more efficient models. Here's how it works. It all starts with your enterprise data and your AI agent interactions. Your production app generates logs with every AI interaction. The flywheel analyzes this data to curate ground truth for your specific use cases and helps them to experiment with smaller, more efficient models. It fine-tunes these models using your production real-world data. It evaluates performance, identifies the best candidate smaller models. You could even guardrail them based on the specific use case you're deploying them for, and continue building on this self-improving cycle. Essentially, the more data you have, the better the optimization becomes. Hence, the flywheel effect. You're continuously observing how your deployed large models behave in production, capturing the data, and using it to distill smaller, cheaper, faster model alternatives that can do the same job at a fraction of a cost. Now that we've understood the data flywheel concept, let's look at what NVIDIA blueprints are. If you're already familiar with NVIDIA blueprints, NVIDIA NIM, and NeMo microservices, feel free to jump to the tutorial part of this video. Otherwise, continue watching. So NVIDIA blueprints are reference AI workflows, pre-trained for specific use cases that can be customized by enterprise developers. They include reference code for constructing the workflow using NVIDIA AI Enterprise Software Suite, including NVIDIA NIM and NeMo microservices, along with tools and documentation for deploying in your own environment and customizing with your own data. They also include a reference architecture, which documents API definitions and how the microservices interoperate and much more. They're available on build.nvidia.com/blueprints. You can find a variety of blueprints and assets to start building with state-of-the-art NVIDIA AI tools for some of the most common agentic use cases. Do check it out. I'll drop the link in the description. The Data Flywheel Blueprint is built on top of two core building blocks from NVIDIA, NVIDIA NeMo microservices and NVIDIA NIM microservices. Let's first take a look at NVIDIA NeMo. It is an end-to-end cloud-native accelerated platform for building, customizing, and deploying generative AI models, a modular stack for LLM training, customization, evaluation, and inference, enabling you to build state-of-the-art generative AI models. Now that you know how to build your models using NVIDIA NeMo, we also encourage you to deploy them as NVIDIA NIM. Think of NVIDIA NIM as an AI model in a pre-built optimized container exposed as an API, so developers can integrate generative AI into applications like never before. NVIDIA NIM are easy to use inference microservices for rapidly deploying the latest AI models, and not just large language models. With NVIDIA NIM, we have helped standardize the complicated deployment of AI models. Link to all of these building block components can be found in the description below. Now that you have understood all the building blocks, let's take a quick look at the Data Flywheel Blueprint architecture. This version of the blueprint is designed to help teams replicate the capabilities of large foundational models, for example, the 70B model in this architecture, with smaller, more cost-efficient alternatives. At the heart of the blueprint, you see a flywheel orchestrator. It is a unified control plane, an API that abstracts the complexity of interacting directly with the underlying NeMo and NIM microservices and coordinates the data flywheel job. Here's how the flywheel works step by step. So it starts with log ingestion. The production prompt and the request logs from the teacher-based model NIM, which is Llama 3.370B in this case, is curated and ingested into the Elasticsearch index. These logs follow the OpenAI compliant request response log format. The orchestrator then uses this log and tags them with the metadata like workload ID and client ID, enabling the system to isolate and process data by task for each agent node. Once the dataset is curated, the orchestrator deduplicates the logs and transforms them into task-aligned datasets for training and fine-tuning and evaluation experiments. Notably, these datasets do not rely on any external ground truth labels, only on the original model responses, eliminating the need for manual labeling. That's a huge savings. These datasets are then stored in the NeMo data store, which are then used by the NeMo customizer or evaluator to fine-tune using LoRA adapters or using LLM as a judge and other custom benchmarks to evaluate the various models for each of the experiments. So in this blueprint, we eventually run three experiments: zero-shot prompting, in-context learning, as well as fine-tuned custom evaluations. So once we are done customizing the model and evaluating them, we identify and pick the best performing candidate model using the evaluation report that is generated, so the developer or IT admin in your team can understand the various experimentation results and surface the best performing smaller model alternative and replace the larger 70B model. The beauty about this is the entire loop can be scheduled or triggered on demand, creating an automated scalable system that continuously and progressively surfaces smaller, faster, and more cost-efficient models, which lowers your inference cost while preserving the accuracy of the larger baseline model. In this case, a 3.21B was found to be as closely accurate as possible to the 70B model and has been promoted to be powering the deployed app. The trigger for the data flywheel can be customized as per your business needs. It could be a new model that enters your model registry, or curating or collecting a predefined number of data records to trigger the evaluation and retraining pipelines. All right, now that we've understood all the building blocks and prerequisites, let's get into the demo. We will set up a data flywheel for a high impact use case, for an agentic tool calling use case. We will replace this larger 70B model with a smaller efficient alternative without compromising on the tool calling accuracy. All notebooks and instructions covered in this demo are made available in the description. For the sake of this tutorial and to abstract the hardware dependencies, we will use NVIDIA Launchable. NVIDIA Launchable provides one-click deployable GPU development environments that eliminate all the setup complexity. Think of it as a pre-built sandbox that you can set up in just 2 to 3 minutes to run your AI workloads on GPU clusters, like the Data Flywheel Blueprint in this case. It offers a unified interface across multiple cloud providers, AWS, Google Cloud, Azure, and others, automatically finding the right GPU type at the best price. All right, I'll pass it on to my colleague Sashank to walk you through a quick demo on setting up the Data Flywheel Blueprint from scratch. Broadly, they involve getting the NGC API key, deploying the NeMo microservices platform, cloning this notebook repository, and that's it. You're good to go. Let's get started. Over to you, Sashank.
Hi, I'm Sashank Verma, and this is a demonstration of the Data Flywheel Blueprint. Today, I'll show you how this blueprint can optimize your existing agent deployment by identifying more efficient models, or NIMs, that can match the same accuracy. The goal of this blueprint is to provide a reference implementation of a data flywheel leveraging components from the NeMo microservices platform. Let's get right into it. What is a data flywheel? It's a process that leverages data collected from production applications like LLM prompt and response logs and end-user feedback to improve the application over time, either by finding cheaper NIMs, thereby reducing total cost of ownership, or more accurate NIMs for the same budget. It can do so by running a series of experiments, including customization, in-context learning, as well as model evaluation. Now let's take a look at how you can use this Data Flywheel Orchestrator service that we have created. We have released a Jupyter notebook that shows how to use the REST API. And you can find it right over here in the Data Flywheel Blueprint GitHub in the Notebooks folder. The first thing that you will see is that there is a README that explains how the notebook works and the workflow, including prerequisites. The first thing that you will observe is that there is a README associated with the notebook that details how the blueprint works, as well as the prerequisites for hardware and software to run the notebook. However, there is a second route to run this, an NVIDIA Launchable. Let's see how that works. You can go ahead and click on that notebook and click Deploy Now. This will take you to the Launchable page. You can go ahead and click this Deploy Launchable button to create your Launchable. I do have my Launchable already deployed over here, so I'm just going to go and click on Open Notebook. And this will take me to the Jupyter Notebook. The first thing that you will see over here is that there is an architecture diagram of the Data Flywheel Blueprint and how it operates with the NeMo microservices platform. The specific application in focus today is that of an AI virtual assistant for customer service. This agent, or multi-agent system rather, that it answers questions about product purchases on an e-commerce website. These questions can include requests for product details, order status checks, return processing, as well as small talk and casual engagement. You can find more information about this AI virtual assistant application at build.nvidia.com, as well as an associated blueprint card for it. For the purposes of this data flywheel blueprint, we will simply leverage the user and agent interaction logs generated from that multi-agent system. And we will use these logs to improve the various candidate models involved. Now let's go right ahead and get started with the setup portion of this. The first thing that you want to do is set an NGC API key, followed by cloning the Data Flywheel Blueprint GitHub repo, setting the right paths and dependencies, and then finally, we set the configuration for the blueprint. Now, this is a very important cell. The first configuration we make is to set the LLM judge model and point it to a remote endpoint. By doing so, we don't need to deploy this model locally, and we can simply hit that external endpoint to run evaluations on the candidate NIMs in our search space. The second configuration that you will see over here is to select the candidate NIMs that should be part of your search space and whether or not the blueprint should try customizing it. Finally, once we make these configurations, we can get started to deploy first the NeMo microservices platform, followed by the Data Flywheel service. Once these services are deployed, you can optionally configure MLflow for detailed logging of model evaluations as part of the Data Flywheel. And you can do so by running this Docker Compose command over here. Once all these services are running, we're all set to get started. The next step now is to load the sample data provided. This data includes a timestamp of the interaction from the time the request was issued, a workload ID that represents a specific agent node that was logged at. This is especially important in multi-agent systems. A client ID that represents the application itself and is unique to it. A request that was sent to the model. This is an OpenAI chat completion format. And this is followed by a response, which is by default from a Llama 3.370B instruct model. And that is the model that we're trying to distill using this blueprint. Finally, we load that data using Elasticsearch. Followed by that, we can create a flywheel job by sending a post request to the jobs API. This will return with a job ID that you can actually use to monitor the job status by sending a get request to the job/job ID API. You will see certain artifacts of the job reported over here. However, this is an asynchronous call, and so it will return the current status. You will note that in the job status output, after certain evaluations are completed, you will see the following three metrics. In this case, the use case was pertaining to tool calling, and so the metrics it will report is that of tool calling evaluation. Namely, the first is the function name accuracy, which is an exact match metric that checks if the predicted function name exactly matches the ground truth function name. There's the function name plus args accuracy, which is also an exact match metric on both the function name as well as the arguments. It checks if both the function name and args exactly match the ground truth. Now, this is a very strict metric, and so it will be interesting to see how it does in this use case. And the reason is because there are some queries or some arguments that are passed down to tools which are rather long strings. Even if the predicted argument is off by a character, this exact match metric will mark it as zero. So that is exactly why we also have this function name and args accuracy LLM judge metric, which will actually check the arguments for semantic similarity. And so it will capture intent that way. Finally, to view the evaluation results, once they're ready, you can use the MLflow integration that we have at port 5000. So if you're using this via the launchable route, you can actually find that dashboard right over here in the secure link section at port 5000. Let's click on this one. We'll take you to the MLflow dashboard. And you can see that I have three experiments that are captured over here. The specific cell that was running was this one with 300 data points. You will observe that there are three different models logged over here, the Llama 3.21b, 3.23b, and Llama 3.18b models across three different types of evaluation. First for the base model, then for few-shot learning or in-context learning evaluation, and finally evaluating a customized version of it. You can go ahead and select them and compare these runs. MLflow will report detailed evaluation results, including a lot of different kinds of metrics. Look at a scatter plot of the run name, which will be specific to the models and the type of evaluation that was run on them. The mean correctness rating, which is the LLM judge metric for both function name and args. Here we can see that the Llama 3.18b is outperforming the rest so far, and this is just on 300 data points. It scores close to 75%. On this specific metric, note that 100% on this data set means that it is 100% close to the Llama 3.370b model, which is the one that it's trying to distill. And back inside the notebook, once the cell gets completed, it will display a table of all the different kinds of metrics that are available for the specific case, including function name accuracy, the exact match metric. And in this case, we can see that a customized version of a Llama 3.21b instruct model can come close to 83% of the accuracy of a Llama 3.370b model. And then the 8b customized is actually at 98%. Let's see now what happens if we increase the number of records that are available to the Flywheel service. Next, we do a job with 500 records. We see that a custom 1b model now comes close to 95% in terms of function name accuracy. Let's take it up a notch. What happens with 1,000 records now? We do another run. In this time, we see that the Llama 3.21b instruct model, a custom version of it, comes close to 96%, and then 71% in terms of the function name and args accuracy, which is the LLM judge metric. In this case, we were able to find that a custom version of a model as small as 1b can come close to the accuracy of a model 70 times its size, that is the Llama 3.370b. And there you have it. We've seen how using the Data Flywheel service, you can run evaluation experiments on various models, including customizations, and find much smaller variants, thereby reducing the total cost of ownership. Thank you for watching.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Sashank. I hope this was a good precursor to think about building data flywheels and adopting the Data Flywheel Blueprint from NVIDIA. Though we showcased an agentic tool calling in this video, you can easily extend it to any of your downstream agentic use cases that you're building and running on your infra, on cloud, on-prem, or even edge. Hope this was motivation enough to start thinking about building data flywheels to optimize for inference cost and managing your compute. The blueprint is available on build.nvidia.com, and we'll drop the link in the description as well. Thank you for watching.